Hey, this is Phil, and I've got something cool to show you today. This is a 2023 Chevrolet Silverado with gas. And no, it's not the electric version of the truck, it's gas, Google Automotive Services. And so you may have seen these vehicles at your dealership that have gas and they have a Google Assistant on board, but this one has Alexa as well. And that's what we're going to be talking about in this vehicle. So a whole other kind of gas, not to be confused with ICE, which is internal combustion engine. So let's jump inside and take a look. All right, we're inside the 2023 Silverado. And the first thing you're gonna notice is how easy.
What are you doing talking to yourself in the truck?
I'm not talking to myself, I'm making a video.
I see that. And so, are you doing selfies?
Not selfies, well, maybe a few selfies along the way.
If I was as handsome as Phil, I'd do a selfie too.
So this is my neighbor, Rich. You may know him better as Spyder Harrison on SiriusXM Hits 1, or you look like your
evil twin brother, J.J. Walker.
On 70s mm-hmm. on 7, who
plays
kind of slow music on Friday nights.
All right, cut it out. That's what Phil says.
And also, you're on the 10 spot.
I'm on the spot right now because I didn't know I was in your video.
So 10 spot playing music for the 2010s, right. if that's the kind of music you like to listen to. But what we're talking about is Alexa. And you remember the last car I had, the Cadillac XT6.
That's pretty cool,
beautiful car. It had Alexa in it. But this is a gas vehicle that came with Google Automotive Services. Google Automotive Services.
It's not an electric.
Not electric. So it's not a
Google. Hyper. Oh, I get it. Google Assistant. I get it.
And so what we're going to show you today is now it's possible to have Alexa along with Google Assistant in your vehicle.
I think she just heard you.
She just heard me. She knows it's coming. Alexa, stop. It's okay. So the first thing that you're going to discover with this, and you're in a perfect position to see this, is how easy it is to discover Alexa. It's gone are the days of searching all over the place trying to find Alexa. She's front and center right here on
Alexa.
This car. Right there. You see that Alexa icon there.
But
and
you don't have to, but you have to press it.
You have to press it to get started, but you don't have to go to a Google Play Store. You don't have to go to any kind of an app shop. It's
so
right
there. If I want to access Alexa, I have to hit the screen? Is that what I mean?
For the first time setup.
Oh, yeah. And then you don't have to, after that?
Then you don't have to do it anymore.
So it's just voice activated.
Voice activated.
So if I'm driving, I could just say, and that's, Alexa.
Right. That's the
play
best
the
part.
Weekend countdown on SiriusXM.
And that's just like you're being like you're at home, right? So,
right.
So hey, come on around. We'll get you inside
right.
the front and we'll
that's
go
cool.
over the details. All right. Let's start with navigation.
All right. So like what all cars have navigation,
right?
So you're saying Alexa controls the navigation?
Yeah.
Yeah, she does. Alexa, take me to navigate to SiriusXM on Avenues of America, New York City.
There is a SiriusXM Studios, 593.5 miles away on 1221 Avenue of the Americas.
That's it.
Do you want to get directions to that one?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Getting directions to SiriusXM Studios at 1221 Avenue of the Americas.
That's pretty cool. So, you know, what about like music? It's like, I'll give it a shot, right? It's just like at home, right?
Yep.
Alexa, play the weekend countdown on SiriusXM.
Playing the weekend countdown from SiriusXM. Resuming the latest episode, May 6th.
Aww.
You just made my day.
What did we say?
I don't know. That was kind of funny.
You should use that.
Use that. Yeah, I'll definitely use that.
Thank you, Alexa. You're so sweet. Alexa, you're the greatest.
Wahoo! My day just went from great to absolutely perfect.
So you know how to talk to her, so that's pretty cool. There's something that we want to talk about really quick. There's some new stuff that's kind of nice, and it always gets better. She always gets better. And so watch this. You could say something this is what's called the disambiguation property, where
what?
You could say, Alexa,
say that again?
Disambiguation.
Okay.
Alexa, play KTU.
I can't find the requested station near you. but I did find 1035 KTU from iHeartRadio. Would you like me to play this instead?
Yes.
1035 KTU from iHeartRadio.
That's my favorite frequency. 1035.
103.5. Somebody keyed it in wrong.
No, that's fine.
It's amazing that she can figure out that those letters KTU are a station in New York and play it without having to have the frequency, without having to have the full call letters. Pretty impressive how it does that.
Alexa, play John Mayer, Gravity.
All right. Gravity by John Mayer from Tidal.
You have Tidal on this thing?
Yeah.
That's cool.
You use your own subscription.
Oh, I see.
So if you have one,
Then it connects to the Alexa.
Yeah. And then, so then you could even Spotify, where you could say, Alexa, play today's hits on Spotify.
I turned it down because because
today's
of copyright.
Top hits from Spotify.
Oh, yeah. We brought it. Keep it low. Hey, well, there you have it, a preview of Alexa on a vehicle with Google Automotive Services.
I'm impressed.
Pretty
so,
cool.
So, you know, because like in my car, I got to press something on my steering wheel for the phone. I got to press something on my console for other things. It's confusing. And it's nice to do it just like at home because I have Alexas all over my house.
It's crazy over there. He's like the cat lady of Alexa. And so with this, you just say Alexa and do it. And it's so much faster. That's the coolest part.
And if I don't get home faster, Marjorie's having David and Heather over, my neighbors, and I gotta get.
You gotta get.
She's gonna wonder where I am. So, well, Phil was doing a video. Yeah. So what's that have to do with you?
All right. So we'll play out the video with some additional features and functionality that you could do with Alexa in your vehicle with gas. And if you've got some cool features, you can put them in the comments. And if there's any suggestions of things that you would like to see that you can do on Alexa in the vehicle, let me know. And as always, thanks for watching. Bye.
All right. Now you gotta take me home.
All right.
I forgot to tell you. I walked here and I don't want to walk back.
That's right.
Right?
Yep.
Hey. Alexa. Uh-oh. Whoa! Tell Phil's tripod to stay still.
That's not gonna work.
No, it doesn't work.
Yeah.
Alexa doesn't can't do that.
Yeah. Alright.
Alright. So Alexa. Play Watercolors on SiriusXM.
Tripod's crooked.
You can hold it.
Yeah.
Your video is very professional. It's such a nice day. It's a good day to do a video.
It's a great day to do a video.
It's a great day in the neighborhood to do a video with your buddy Phil DeVille. That's your air name.
That's my air name now. Yeah.
Phil DeVille.
Phil DeVille.
Incredible Phil DeVille.
The incredible Phil DeVille.
Yeah, it does sound good. Port English Oak Court.
Alexa, play the incredible Phil DeVille. Oh, she doesn't recognize that. This is how close I live to the world famous Phil DeVille.
Oh,
it's exactly 3 minute drive except when Phil drives. It's only a 2 minute drive. And Phil can probably run here faster than you drive. Whoa, no. The neighbors are gonna that's Phil and Rich again.
Yeah.
Last week Phil terrorized the neighborhood in our buddy Fred's six passenger golf cart. And when I say terrorize the neighborhood, I mean it. Here, there's Fred's house. Oh, where's the golf cart? He must be out for a ride. Or Brian stole it. Our neighbors steal his golf cart all the time. And Phil did last week.
Rerouting us to Sirius headquarters.
Who?
Alexa.
Oh, it's there. Okay. There's the home sweet homeness. See how close I am to Phil? He's would be much further away when Phil lived in Seattle. Yeah. And then we forced him to move here because it would be nice. And you don't regret it, do you? Wait. Oh, you don't regret it, do you?
No, this is a great place.
It's a beautiful place. But we don't want you to guys. Yeah.
Hey, this is Phil. We are inside the Silverado with Gas, Google Automotive Services. And there's just a couple things that I wanted to talk about. And the first one is, if you have a vehicle that has Google Automotive Services on it right now, you have Google Assistant. And so with Google Assistant, you're able to do, you know, a lot of the things that you can do with Alexa. But in the video today, we're going to be talking about Alexa because it's new. And so, and if you like Alexa and you use Alexa in your home, like I do, you know, Alexa comes natural to you as your own in-vehicle virtual assistant. And so there's been a lot of talk about, you know, what would it be like if there was no Apple CarPlay in the car. And so, you know, if you think about it, you know, when you watch TV on a smart TV, you don't plug your phone in, you don't tether your phone to your TV. So in the car, if you're able to have, you know, the same kind of a platform where you're able to have all the apps that you like and enjoy, and to be able to do it without connecting your phone, without having to worry about Bluetooth, well, it's a great thing. And so with both Google Assistant and with Alexa, you can be hands-free and use what's called wakeword. And so with Google Assistant, you just say, "Hey Google," and then you say whatever it is that you want to do, like navigation or music or whatever it is. But then with Alexa, you're able to say Alexa as the wake word and do your command. Very seamless, very quick, and they both listen and are able to execute your commands very quickly. So with that said, we're going to dive in and show some of the Google Automotive Services features, but having Alexa chosen as the virtual assistant. And so we'll go through these pretty quickly. There's a lot of things that you can do. This will not be a comprehensive, you know, demo by any means, but the idea is just to show you what it's like to have Alexa as your virtual assistant, be able to do everything hands-free, no more fumbling with your phone, trying to do projection and the CarPlay stuff. You're able to do all of this on your vehicle. And one of the things also that you're going to want to see in this demo is the beautiful screen. It's a 13.8 inch screen with a great 16:9 orientation, which is just absolutely great for showing navigation and having split screens where you can see your music and see multiple things at the same time on the screen. And it's just very nice, very intuitive, and a lot of fun to use. So let's dive in. We'll show all the details of the features, and hopefully you'll enjoy this.
Alexa, navigate to Costco.
There is a Costco 10.9 miles away on 211 West Blackstock Road. Do you want to get directions to that one?
Yes.
Getting directions to Costco at 211 West Blackstock Road.
Alexa, let's stop at a Starbucks along the way.
There is a Starbucks 6.6 miles away on 2000 South Pine Street. Do you mean that one?
Yes.
Okay, adding Starbucks to your route.
There we go. All right, let's talk about infotainment now for a minute. It's so easy to use your voice and control that with the virtual assistant in the vehicle. So let's do a couple quick things. And notice that there's no carrier phrase on most SiriusXM channels. So a lot of the channels, almost all of them, you're able to just directly say what you want like this. You can just say, Alexa, play Classic Rewind.
All right. Classic Rewind from SiriusXM.
Hey Alexa, play Hits 1.
SiriusXM Hits 1 from SiriusXM.
All this together,
man. Nah, man. Fast pass. Help me out, brothers.
877-5-HITS-1. And then if you want to hear other music sources, we could say, you got, let's say that you want to hear music on Tidal, Spotify, any of those, you could just say, Alexa, play BB Rexa.
Playing songs by BB Rexa from Tidal.
All right, there you go. You can hear that. And then let's say you want to, you've got something on Spotify you want to hear. Alexa, play today's top hits.
Today's top hits from Spotify.
There you go. And then you can also tune to your favorite radio stations. Like you could say, Alexa, tune to
96.1. 96.1 from FM radio.
There you go. So you can do that. You can play all your favorite music stations. And then if, of course, if you want to hear stuff on iHeartRadio, you can just say, Alexa, play Z100 New York.
Z100 from iHeartRadio.
Notice how easy that is. There's not a lot of extra stuff you have to say. You don't have to specify iHeartRadio and do all that kind of stuff. And even if there's a station that, you know, you could just do like partial, you know, station names. She's very good at being able to, you know, figure out what it is that you're trying to say, and uses what they call a disambiguation property, where the voice assistant is able to figure out what it is that you intended to say and make logical choices. And you can use Alexa to make phone calls and receive phone calls, either making phone calls to a phone number, a 10-digit phone number, or you could also make phone calls by name, where you could say, you know, call Bob Jones. And Alexa will do that as well. In addition, you could tie in all of your home automation items, and you could have those controlled by saying, Alexa, turn on garage lights.
Okay.
Alexa, what's the temperature upstairs?
The upstairs temperature is 72 degrees.
Alexa, how does my day look?
Phil, here's what I found. Dentist, on June 6th at 9 a.m.
All right. Light calendar today. Alexa, add Verona K-Cups.
What can I add for you?
Add Starbucks Verona K-Cups to my shopping cart.
A best-selling option is Starbucks K-Cup coffee pods, dark roast coffee, Cafe Verona for Keurig Arabica, 4 boxes. It's $74.09. With delivery by May 10th. I added it to your Amazon cart for review. To purchase, say buy it now.
Hey, well, there you have it. Some great features showing Alexa in vehicle, and a vehicle with Google Automotive Services. Showed you some cool stuff about how you're able to use Alexa hands-free, just like you would at home with the wake word, just by saying Alexa. And then also using Alexa to do your navigation, which is a lot of fun, and tying that in with Google Maps, which is really cool. And then also we showed you some infotainment, showing you how you could tune to all your favorite SiriusXM stations, and just by saying the names of the station or the channel numbers, and then also playing your favorite music from various music services like Spotify and Tidal, and then also how you can tune to FM and AM stations by using your voice. And of course, you know, some of the staples of being in the vehicle, you like to make phone calls, receive phone calls, and you can do that with Alexa as well. And then plus tying in all your smart devices like your home automation, your lighting, setting your thermostats, all that fun stuff. You can do that, control it, and check in on it while you're driving by using your voice and just having Alexa do that for you. And then plus adding stuff to your shopping cart and checking your calendar and even adding items to your calendar as well. Those are all the things that you can do. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope if you've got a vehicle that's got Google Automotive Services on it, you're able to install Alexa and have it up and running in your vehicle and use it as a voice assistant. It really is a game changer and something that saves you a lot of time and a lot of frustration while you're driving, and hopefully it helps you keep your eyes on the road. So with that, we'll close out the video, and thanks for watching. Hey, you're still here. The video's over. All right, I'm turning off the camera. Another video's coming soon, I promise. Bye.